So I take that nobody has any public comment. Okay, so let's go on to facility. Mr. McGee.
First section is the septic system. As you're aware, we've been dealing with some issues regarding the septic system this year, where we've undertaken several steps to investigate issues that might exist with our septic system. One of the things that we faced was we ended up with a student who had come that they had ended up stepping in some water on the playground that had a foul smell to it. As you will recall, we roped off that area of the playground and immediately began, we immediately notified the Ravalli County sanitarian, as well as started taking steps to investigate what had occurred with our septic system, whether we had issues with it or not. During the course of different tests that we had ran, we came across issues with pumps where, you know, we weren't sure if certain pumps were cycling correctly, if they were operating at full capacity. One of the things that we had discovered was that there was some rock that was gravel rock that was in the bottom of a dosing chamber where the main pumps are that pump gray water into the drain field. But one thing that we were certain of is that the drain field wasn't functioning the way that it was set up and designed it to function. So we did some further investigation and changed out some pumps and brought in the fire department to run a test where they pumped thousands of gallons into the dosing chamber, and we ran tests to determine the rate of flow into the laterals of the drain field. Terry Forrest with DJ&A Engineering, Terry was involved the last time the septic drain field was dealt with back in 2005. So we brought his firm in to do the investigation on this issue because his firm's familiarity with the engineering that had taken place previously on the drain field. And from that testing with the fire department, Terry, I'm going to turn it over to you and let you talk a little bit with what occurred once the fire department had introduced all of that water into the dosing chambers and what your firm found at that point. And we have a podium here.
If that helps you.
And we'll just sit here.
That's okay, we don't mind.
Okay. What we found that day when we did the testing, and Dennis helped a lot on that, is one of the pumps, it took 10 minutes approximately to pump the water out down about 460 gallons. That's the cycle, 11 inches, to pump it out, and it was gone. The other two never did quit, and it was over 45 minutes on each one. So what it amounted to, and we didn't run several tests, we just ran this one for a couple hours, but what it amounted to was there was more liquid coming in that could get pumped out. So, and it in fact increased while we ran the second and third pumps. So the first pump, it was a little less flow in, and it pumped out in 10 minutes. The other two, we estimated it would be at least 50 minutes each before it got pumped out. So there's something funny about those two pumps. They are brand new, they're identical. The controllers are brand new and identical. So it really can't be the pumps. At that point, we had the rocks had been taken out, and there were some pretty good sized ones in there, which I have no clue how they got in there. About a gallon bucket or a gallon milk jug full of them. So what we started looking at, and I got back to my office and I started thinking about and talking it over with one of the other people back there, was the two that weren't working are the two oldest drain fields. And they're not chamber drain fields. They're just a plain drain fields like you probably all have at your house. A pipe in the ground with little holes in it, and it pumps. And they've been in there for a lot of years. In the meantime, while we were talking, something came up. I asked Dennis, What happens in the summer times when you guys are cleaning your floors, waxing them, stripping them, and all that stuff? And he says, well, I've never seen anybody hauling that stuff out and dumping it someplace and then collecting it. He thinks it's going down the drains. And to me, it just like lit up a light. That's what's been going out into your drain field every summer, is wax and stripper. And it ends up out there. And so I was looking at a picture tonight that I just wanted to quickly show you at least one. And this is probably as good a one as any. Just look at these three pictures. What we did back in 2005 is we cut a hole in the newest drain field, which is a chamber, which means a plastic chamber that's hollow. We dug it down, we cut a hole in it, I stick my head in it, or I stuck the camera in it to get these pictures. And it was, the surface was lined with something, the bottom floor was lined with something, and it was kind of drooping down type of thing. So what was happening is the water would come in, it would squirt out, and it would fall on this very impervious material. I took a piece of it home to my office. Shouldn't say home, my wife wouldn't let me bring it in. But I took it to my office and I put it in a quart jar. It was about this big. And it sat there for more than a year and it never disintegrated. It never did anything. I got in there one day, I was moving some stuff and I took it out and it was just as brittle as it was when I looked at it, when I broke it off and brought it home. So I don't know that that's all wax, if some of it's grease, if whatever else may have come through there. I'm still thinking that there's a lot coming through that filter that's out there, but the water that's coming into the dosing chamber is really quite clean. I mean, you look at it, it's quite clean. You look at the water in the bottom, it's quite clean. I mean, you can't see to the bottom. I mean, it's dirtier than that, but it's really quite clean. It's not a bunch of floaty stuff or anything like that. So it kind of hinted that there's a problem out in the drain fields. The one pump that took 10 minutes to run is the pump that goes to the newest drain field, the chamber. The other two are the ones that took 50, and they're in the old system of just a septic drain field that's plugged. And that means it's come out of the hole. Some of the holes are probably plugged, or the slots, one of the two, and the area right around the pipe, if it's the same stuff that you're taking looking at, it's just coated in. And it's a mess. So what I looked at then was, what can we do to fix your system? And I think obviously one of the things that we want to do, and it's because a room is a big reason, is the, do you want me to go into this much depth?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is the domes or the chambers. They take less room area-wise than a regular drain field. So what I did is I called DEQ and I asked them if they would have a problem with me putting in a bed rather than a drain field where you put in trenches. A bed is you go excavate a big area out and you lay these domes right next to each other. And then you fill them in and you're done. And then in between the domes, what I'm proposing, it's about a 10-foot area where somebody could drive a vehicle, and somebody, there's sort of an impervious, more of an impervious area between them, so that the water that comes down here won't instantly go over to this area. I want it to stay kind of where it's at, so we have good distribution of the liquid. I've sized the drain fields to quite a bit more liquid than the original one was sized, because I go with DEQ typical requirements, and I take the average for what they say, and I'm using 460 people on that system. Maybe a little bit more, I don't want to know if it's a little more. I'm using that number. They say take 25 gallons. The maximum is 25. We took 20 gallons. I'm sorry. We took 25 gallons a day. That's the average. 15 to 30 is the number. Took 25, it came out to be 11,500 gallons a day. That's humongous. You don't hardly have enough grass over there to put that in. So I went back and I tried to get some other numbers because of the recordings that Dennis has been taking of how much water's been trapped out there and this, that, and the other thing, and I came up with 6,400. So, and I think I can justify it. I talked to DEQ about it, and they didn't seem to have a problem with that number either. So I base all my calculations on 6,400 gallons a day. The area where you have the drain field now, I thought there was a bulletin board in here. So the area where you have your drain field, kind of, let me just do a little quickie drawing here. Kind of looks like this. With God damn it! Okay, I didn't draw it quite right. North is this way. Okay, this is a septic tank, which incidentally is I haven't found an exact number, but I did find back in 91 they assumed it was 10,000 gallons. And if you go with 6,400 gallons a day, I need another 5,000 gallon tank to add to this. And if we're going to do a major revamping of the system, we'll have to put in a smaller tank, but it'll have to be in there. You need 15,000 gallons. Goes into that octagonal, this is the dosing chamber right here. And then it goes down into kind of another tank that's here. It's like a 6-foot diameter manhole type of thing. And what I would propose to do is to put a bunch of valves in there and then run lines out to the system. But that's what you have right now, is lines, three lines comes out of here because there's three pumps in here. And there's one line that goes to this drain field, one line that goes to this one, and one line that goes to this one. That's what you have right now. And where this one is located, this edge, well, this edge is over here by a fence. This edge is kind of over here by a fence. And this edge is kind of in line with that building, that taller building that's right there. That's the drain field area, if you will. When I put mine in there, what I'm going to need to do is put in one here, and one there. Something like that.
You're talking new drain field.
Brand new.
Okay, now, so you have three boxes there, but did you say that the one field, you had the chambers in already, and we don't have to, do we have to redo that one also?
I'm proposing that we reuse the chambers, but put in a new one, okay. And so it can be smaller,
okay.
Is the idea. Because I'm going to make a bed out of them, which are the ones right next to each other.
Okay.
And, yeah, that one out here.
Okay.
So, this is kind of what I'm doing, and I'm using the whole area, but I need a replacement area. So I'm going to have to tell them that the area over here, which is grass, is the replacement area. And in my mind, there's no intention ever to use that as a replacement area, because quite frankly, you've got another system over here.
I'm a little confused. Our current drain fields right now are what, on the
North Star Playground?
There's two there.
Three there,
and so they're all. That's all our current drain fields are on there, or right there. That's where we're talking.
That's the high school part of them. There's another set of drain fields between those two.
On the south side.
On the south side of the elementary. That's right. The other, and then the other one's farther north over here by high school. That's mm-hmm. our three drain fields.
So you have three.
No, there's three drain fields on the north side, and there's four drain fields over there.
So we have a total of seven drain fields current.
Yeah.
All right.
And I've never done anything with the ones on the south side. I looked at them the last time I was here. There's a very small septic tank. Doesn't meet any criteria. And then there's a gravity dosing system with a little pump in it in a 4-foot diameter manhole?
That's the four on the south, so that, are those the ones that we put in back originally, like in 92, am I correct in saying that? You don't know?
The ones in 91 were new at, the one with the domes was put in 91, or 92. The other ones have been there a long time.
Prior to 91, 92?
Yes.
Okay.
And I have no clue when the ones on the south side were put in. Those are sitting over here by those nets, between the nets kind of, and there's just four of them in a row.
You don't have how they function in, you don't know?
No. But
we haven't had any issues with them.
Right. But I've looked in the dosing tank, if you want to call it that. There's one little bitty pump in there which isn't doing anything. I'm not even sure it works. It's full of bad stuff. I mean, the filter, there's no filter on the septic tank. I have no clue how that went.
So you're planning on just keeping it going and continuing use on it? And then you're talking about, so the other three on the north that have side are the ones you're saying that are failing?
That's right.
Now you're talking to put new drain fields where?
The same place those three are right now.
So how do you go about that? You're saying we dig up our existing drain fields? What do you do with the soil that's up?
Typically, when you dig up a drain field, you abandon the drain field, you don't have to do anything with the soil, like haul it to a special place or anything like that. You dig it up, mix it around, you could put it somewhere else. I'm not sure at school you'd want to put it on the surface, but you could do things with it. But by putting these systems in that I'm talking about here, which is a gravel bed, which looks like this, whole bunch of them right next to each other. And what's in there right now is a trench with a pipe in the middle. Up here's the ground surface. There's a pipe in the middle here. We're gonna go in and dig this up. Take the pipe out and dig out approximately 2 feet by 2 feet and haul it away somewhere, wherever you guys want to take it. Whoever will take it, when you gotta go to a landfill, I don't believe you will. But you'll take it somewhere.
It's sewer. Yeah. Imagine you got to take it. I'm sure there's restrictions where it's got to go.
Well, we'll talk with the county sanitarian.
Right.
And get a plan on how to deal with the material.
So I'm trying to figure out what you got. I wish we had a bigger board. You could draw it easier to understand.
But we got a board here.
It's all right. My question is, okay, we have these existing drain fields, and you're gonna replace them, am I correct in saying that? Okay, when you say you're replacing them, you're not digging them up. You are digging them up, okay, and you're taking these drain fields out. Am I correct in saying that? And you're putting in new drain fields in the existing soil and everything that's there. Is that what you're telling me?
These drain fields, I haven't dug any of these up or anything, but this distance from here to the surface is typically 18 inches.
Okay.
What I'm going to be digging down is I'm going to have 18 inches here and plus another foot, because these are beds. There's soil in between these trenches. I mean, that's just soil. It's about 7 feet apart, something like that. And so what I was thinking originally was, you dig these trenches out, you're going to have a certain kind of waste. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and dig out a great big area, five times the size of this room, this deep, and then put in gravel or washed rock or something like that, and then lay these all out.
These new drain fields. Now that surface you're pulling out, you're saying is bad soil?
No, I'm saying just this soil right here is bad soil.
Right around the pipe.
2 feet by 2 feet is kind of what I'm saying. However long they are, usually they're 80 feet or 70 feet is what my drawings show. And that is the special soil.
Okay.
But there's a whole bunch of other soil there too that we're going to put back over the top. But these mounds, you know, the soil we're hauling out here is kind of the same size as this mound.
So if we remove like a 2 foot by 2 foot section of dirt, it's 100 foot long, are we going to have to bring in a 2 foot by 2 foot section of dirt to replace it?
No.
Because the domes are going to take up the space.
Yeah, this will take up the space.
Okay.
I've heard really good things about the homes. I mean, that's the new way of doing septic systems. I mean, it's, you can get a lot more with a less amount of
trenches and domes.
Right.
More efficient.
Yeah.
Yep, you get more of it out of it, no question about it.
What, I mean, how long, what you're saying, this fix, how long is this?
This should be 30, 40 years.
30, 40 years. What was the lifetime expectancy of our old one? Do you have any idea?
20.
20?
And the problem, and maybe not even quite 20, because it's a school. If it was at your house, there's lots of drain fields at people's houses that are older than 20 years. They kind of watch what they put down the sink. They don't dump oil, grease, you know, they don't have garbage disposals, all that kind of stuff. At a school, not only do you have cooking taking place here, which I have no clue how your grease traps are set up or anything like that, but those people, those custodian type people that are dumping the stuff into the system, I mean, I think that is what's causing the problem.
So that's what's causing us to fail. It's not the fact that we're just, drain fields got no more, they're soil saturated, wasted, and it's nowhere to go. That's what you're telling me.
I think it's basically not allowing it to go down, because the soil down at this level should be pretty dang patient and it should go. But what happens is it's kind of plugged. So consequently it kind of works its way up in the soil. And then they got the little baseball diamond and the bases. Right where the bases are, every one of them is a little piece like this. And if this, from here to here, is only a foot, and you do this, and it's over years, pretty soon you're down this far, you're getting closer and closer to where the water's coming up.
And that's where the water, where the kids have their base paths on that diamond, is where there were indentations in the surface, and that's where the water came.
So it's seeping all the way down, you're saying, all the way down to the baseball field?
Oh, no. On that playground.
On the playground.
On the playground, there's an iron backstop. So where the kids with that old backstop, they like to get out there and play kickball or baseball on it during recess. They create base paths, and where first, second, and third base are over the drain field, where the bases would typically be, indentations have been created in the surface.
So we have no more room for a new drain field anywhere else. Our option would be to start pumping up, is that right? Or going farther towards the highway.
But you don't
say in east or west.
You don't have any ground, do you? Is there?
Well, we got, don't we own up in here?
Well, we own 20 acres right here.
Oh, so you do own this?
We own this right here. But we also, you know, down by the softball field where people.
We own to the highway there.
We own to the highway there, so there's area down.
And we tried to buy that Ostrich place because that's 5+ acres, and we would have room to expand with that.
So am I right in saying that it would be better to have a new drain, total new area of drain field, if we have that option?
If you had the option of not having a drain field on a children's playground, yes. I would say yes. But I looked at the area down by the football field, or the track, where they park cars. It's not big enough. You're going to lose pretty much those trees.
What about under the football field?
You don't want, don't you do, is that a football field or is it a track?
Well,
field?
It's track.
It's too much stuff. No, I wouldn't suggest that at all. You'd get too many people on it, walking, heavier, the whole bit.
And pumping, if we own property up here, you could pump up?
Yeah, absolutely.
So I'm assuming
but it would certainly cost more.
I'm assuming that's, I haven't heard the cost on where we're going on this, but I'm assuming it's 3-4 times that, half of what?
Well, it'd be at least 2 or 3 times it. And we're at $100,000 for this one I'm talking about.
And with the chambers now, the way they are, we shouldn't have any seepage should we have seepage that comes from those chambers?
Yes.
Okay.
Most of it goes down.
Down.
But there's about 20% of it, and it's just the way it is,
right,
is that it works its way and then evapotranspiration goes out. It's never enough to create a little puddle, and it's never like that.
But it's not like the existing drain fields.
And is it a health risk to students who play on it as a playground?
I would say, no, it's not a health risk, but the more you play on it and you create lines between first and second base, it packs it down, and then a drain field doesn't do what it's supposed to do. That's why if you go down below, you can't park any cars down there. You know, it's not a choice. You can't do it. You can't have cattle or animals on it. You just should not be on it at all. That's my first inkling. That's why I first asked John, the new one we're putting in, can I chain link fence it off and just not have any kids out there? It'll be the nicest grass. Over here, it won't be as good.
And we can't do that? That's what you're saying?
No, I didn't say we could.
No, he says, you guys would not like to do that because they're so short of playground right now.
So our option is we're putting something in where we don't really want to walk on it, but we have to.
Yes. And I've got a couple of things I can do to make it better. I plan on putting it a foot and a half deep. That'll give you more. I mean, that's this much. Above the top of the dome. But I mean, I'm just trying to work with what I've kind of got here. I didn't realize you own land up here. But if you own some land, you know, the area we're talking about here is, let's say, 100 by 50. So that'd be 5,000 times 3. 15,000 square feet. So divide that by 43. So you're talking probably a third of an acre, something like that, is what you'd need for that. And what you'd end up doing then is taking the pumps out. Yeah, I wouldn't. I'd take the pumps out of the dosing chamber that's there. Use that as the lift station. You'd put two pumps back in there, and they would have to be bigger than the ones that are there. And it would pump it up to some place over here into another dosing chamber with three pumps or four or whatever it ended up being, because I could certainly do it different because I'm trying to use the pumps here. So you end up with, let's just say it's three, plus you build a drain field. So you'd have a dosing chamber and a three-pump system, and you'd convert that down there. I mean, it would be at least double.
How deep would you say it's fouled right now?
I would say probably no more than 6-8 inches underneath the pipe.
So you cleaned everything out, loaded in there with boulders again. It's just like brand new. If I understand that it's probably plugged up through the years. A lot of stuff that's piled up down in there. It turns into glue and everything else. But if you clean that out real good and haul in some oversized rock and stuff, then put your, this area around here is pretty rocky and gravelly anyway. Put your domes in there, it should be just like new.
Isn't that basically what you're talking about doing?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about doing.
Yeah.
Okay. May I ask a question about if we were to pump it up here and then at a future time, which of course is why we have the 20 acres, at some point there could possibly be another school building built up there. Now, would that interfere with how that was set up? Or, I mean, is it something that we could use for a new building also? Probably not.
Like abandon this one and build a whole new one, or kind of use them both?
Use them both.
Abandon, well, I was thinking, well, if we're, because I think what Colby's saying is that if we abandoned that one and pumped and went with a brand new one up here, then is that one in the future, could that one be used for a building if in fact one was built on that acreage? It probably would have to be
resized
to a bigger
one. Well,
the
advantage of moving somewhere with it is when the other one goes bad, which could happen this summer, could happen next year, could happen 10 years from now, who knows. You could pump that one to this one to there.
You're talking about the oldest one.
Yeah, the oldest one. I mean, you're going to...
Which is just set up probably for the lower elementary building. Is that the one that one...
It covers the third grade and hall area and the lower.
Okay.
worst thing here is that I see, I mean, our drain fields are on our playground. No doubt about it. And you're telling me that we shouldn't walk on them. I mean, over, I mean, that, right there, just, that's my biggest concern. And I think it has been. The kids walking in crap is pretty disgusting. And then we're trying to, I mean, this seems like a, you know, a Band-Aid in a sense, a good Band-Aid, but by far not your best choice is what you're, what I'm reading here.
I guess I would agree with that.
But most every residential house, the drain field's right in the yard.
I'd put mine out in the field.
Well, if you got that option.
You're right there, no, because mine is, and it's something that we've had here.
And I agree, but you're saying that, but you don't have, you know, you're talking playground children.
Another thing we gotta keep in mind is a third of an acre, which isn't very much area.
Until the next one fails, which is how much on it?
The same size.
Same size, another playground, so.
Oh, at that point.
My point is that, that's it, that's all. My biggest concern is.
Oh, sure, nobody wants kids playing in sewer water.
When and if this other one fails, which I, you know, that could be tomorrow, I guess, or 10 years down the road, I'm being optimistic, then we could pump that one in. Could we set it up so we could pump that one into those that we have right now? If in fact, then at that point, we decided to make another one and pumped. Is that what you're saying? I mean,
What I'm thinking is that if you keep the ones that are there, that's for 460 kids.
Right.
And if you've got 460 more kids, or maybe even more, because this one, you know, this one can get overtaxed too eventually, although I'm putting in lots of contingencies, but you can't just put this one in the drain field. What you could do is pump it to the lift station.
Right. And then it would go up.
Then it would go up. Correct. Or you could put in some big septic tanks over here, kind of where the one is now, kind of out in the middle of that play yard, that or the asphalt that's there, and then take the whole rest of that and put in some more of these kind of things. So your whole play yard would be covered with these things. Which, I'm not saying, if that's all you have, then that's all you have. If you've got another area, it might be worth looking at, but it's...
But we're looking at doubling or plus the price.
Right. And that exactly. If we were flush with money, that would... Certainly, that would be probably the best choice, but I don't think we're flush with money.
Does this address the problem with the too close to the well down there?
No.
Because that's the other field, right?
That's a completely separate issue.
Maybe we should address that.
How close is it?
We have a French drain that goes into the ground that collects all of the roof drain water that's within the mixing zone of our...
So you're more than 100 feet from this area here, though?
Oh, yeah. We're okay. Well away from that area.
Yeah, that's a completely separate...
Separate issue.
We're high water right now, so I'm assuming even up here this time of year is when more water goes into that drain field anyway, just from natural runoff from... Is that correct?
I think that the data that I've seen, as far as water goes, it's at least 6 feet down over there.
So this has never affected our drinking water ever, but we've never had an issue with that?
Oh, no, it doesn't affect our drinking water because we're well away from our well.
And you do have good, I mean, it goes whoosh. I mean, it doesn't like this.
Because we're in a very rocky area.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit of a valley.
So that basically covers the issue with the drain field. You know, one of the things that we're faced with, and one of the reasons why a special board meeting was called for, is because we've got an extremely tight schedule. One of the issues and concerns that I have is a disruption to the educational environment of the students. The last thing I want to see is us without a septic system for the start of next school year. And so I'm talking with Terry Forrest of DJ&A about scheduling. It sounds to me like it's going to take about 4 weeks for you to design After the 4 weeks of design, it's going to take about 2 weeks for DEQ review. And after the DEQ review, there are bidding requirements that we have. The state of Montana does have a process, it's an alternative process that can be used. It's called alternative project delivery contracts that allows you to forego the normal bidding process to expedite, you know, the schedule on the system, because in this case, if we use the ordinary bidding process, we could easily be into the beginning of the next school year with half of the playground off limits to students, with contractors out there digging and doing the work that they need to. So there is the opportunity to do an alternative contract on it. It is complicated, but I did talk to Terry today. He believes that under normal bidding procedures, we could possibly get you know, the project done where the first week or two of school contractors would be here, but we would have a portion of the drain field operational and taking care of the sewage that's coming in. So I'm going to let Terry kind of talk a little bit about that. But what we do need to do for tonight is end up with a proclamation calling for a budget amendment, because under state law, we have set our general fund budget for the year, and we have to live by that budget. But in this proclamation, we're going to be stating clearly to the Office of Public Instruction that we had an unforeseen need with the school district's septic drain field. And when you have an unforeseen need, then once you make that proclamation, then the local school board has the authority to dip into its general fund reserves and use those monies to address that unforeseen need. And so this fits the criteria of an unforeseen need. And so by doing this proclamation, what it will do is it'll give notice to the community that we have this issue and that the board is taking action with regard to the issue. And then there will be a budget amendment that we will put forth at the next regular school board meeting and an adoption of the budget amendment. In the proclamation, we are looking at asking for about $150,000. And the reason we're asking for that amount is that in the event that bids are let out and they come back a lot more expensive than we had anticipated, we would have the monies available to us through our general fund reserves to utilize up to that $150,000. If instead we were to set the proclamation at $100,000 because we're anticipating that's what the project is going to be, and the project comes in, let's say, at $125,000, we will only have $100,000 of our reserves to use, and then we're going to have to dip into our general operating budget of this next school year for the additional $25,000. So the $150,000 that we're asking for is just, we're expecting to have some contingency money in the event if we need it. If we don't need it, we just revert back to our general fund reserves. And so the board is going to be asked tonight to make a motion on a proclamation calling for, for the school district in the budget amendment process. And in that motion, we will read off what the proclamation state.
Okay, so are we ready to go to a motion?
I'd like to have a couple questions. Just don't want to.
Okay.
Could I talk just a few minutes? Sure. Just to finish up what I was going to talk about in the different projects. One of the things that John and I talked about was this relatively unique way of doing a project and trying to do it fast track. And what I had suggested is that we pre-qualify contractors. In other words, I could send something out tomorrow based on all the stuff I've done so far to any contractors. I mean, we put it in the paper and those kinds of things, or send it to specific people and have them fill out a form that's sort of a qualification form. And what typically happens when you do that is you get a bunch of forms back, let's say 10 or 12, and you go through there and you select three that you think can do the job, has the most experience and those kinds of things that have done this sort of work.
And then what you do is when you, I finish the design, and while DEQ is reviewing it, I send them it, give them a week to bid it. And they give the three bids, just bring them back in, we review them, and we award it to whoever's probably low, because we've already pre-qualified each one.
So you're pre-qualifying three pre-picked generals.
And you're allowed to do that. It's called an alternative, it's under Title 18 of Montana Code, and it's called an alternative project delivery contracts. But it's not quite as cut and dried as Terry just laid it out. The board does have some responsibility here, and some of the responsibility of what the board would have to do is that it would have to make the determination that there is the potential for major disruption to the school. Is there the potential that we would have a major disruption at the beginning of the next school year through the ordinary bidding process? And the answer to that question is, if you are going to have equipment on the playground and you're going to have a portion of your playground fenced off, that is deemed a disruption. Does it have the potential to be a safety issue for the students in the school? If the board concludes that that's a potential, then it can, I really believe that this project meets this criteria. This law was created for these types of instances that help to expedite a project for a public agency so that they can get the job done and not have to worry about additional costs and additional safety issues with regard to the project. However, Terry, you know, also explained that we can go the traditional route of bidding also.
The problem that my company, we've talked over, is that, and I'm not trying to pick on people from the bid room, you send out this questionnaire that you've taken quite a bit of time to make up so that you got to have some criteria that you can judge whether this guy is good or this guy is better. And if this guy is good, can he do the work or not? Well, maybe he still can do the work, but this guy's better. This guy writes better. He explained what he was going to do. He has more experience with domes. This guy's only done three, this guy's done 10. This guy could come back and sue the school and shut the project down, and we wouldn't get it done this summer. I mean, it's as simple as that. So with that in mind, what I did is I went back and looked at other alternatives that we could use. And what I found was is that while the budget gets tighter, and again, I should emphasize, John mentioned 2 weeks for DEQ. I've talked to them. They said they would try very hard to do that, but they aren't guaranteeing it. They have 3 months to do the review officially, but they thought they could get it in 2 weeks. They have more submittals right now than they've had in the last 4 years altogether. Now, things are moving better, and you know, things are happening out there. Economy's getting a little better and that sort of thing. But what I've done is I've taken the project. And because of the way that I'm laying this out, and just remember, this is the goodest, the best one. If we start this in the summer when there's no students here, the 6,400 gallons a day is nothing. I mean, there's no such thing. It may be as small as 1,000 gallons a day, just for the people that are doing things around the school. So we could pump all of that out to this drain field. I could tear these two up and get these in operation. And then come back, or one of them or both of them, come back and pipe this in, do the testing and all the stuff we have to do, and then come back and then do this one. Well, these two are working. And I guess what I'm thinking is that I would have more room to not shut your school down. I mean, if you don't have bathrooms, you don't have anything here. Because there's no way that I think that you can pump the septic tank, and if we're figuring that there's 6,400 gallons a day, when really there may be 4,000, I mean, it's always expanded, 4,000 gallons a day, that's a pumper truck every day coming and pumping out your septic tank. And 4,000 gallons at probably 50 cents a gallon, something like that, that's 2,000 gallons a day. And there's no way you can pay it. There's no way we can make somebody else pay it.
Well,
that'll be the project.
Say, I mean, where did this $150K come? Where did we get the bid? How do we know? Where did we get the $150,000 number? You're the engineer, correct? So you're looking at your engineering fee. that's included in here, and then you've already, and then you've...
Calculated the quantities.
Calculated the quantities, and you know what our general contractors, you're guesstimating what their bids are gonna be?
And I tried to bid it high.
$150,000.
My number's 100. John's trying to put some contingency in there in case something else goes on.
Who are your three generals that you have, you pre-picked them already?
No, I don't, no idea whatsoever.
So you're just saying to get, do that to save time?
Yeah.
Rather than go, but we do...
He's still gonna advertise it, and he's gonna send out this questionnaire to anybody who responds to that, right? And then the people who choose to respond are the people who are gonna get looked at, and then you pick at the best people. So the contractors are gonna see the advertisement, they're gonna have a chance to respond, and have, based on how well they do to that, whether they get selected to be one of the three or four guys, or however many we gotta have.
I really understand all that. My question is, was back to money, I'm just trying to figure out where we came up with $150,000.
I did all the quantities, the pipe, the length of pipe, there's 6,400 feet of pipe, and chambers. Chambers are $10 a foot.
So we're saying, then back to your question I have for you, John, is you're saying this is a, we're going off the fact that this is an unforeseen need. I mean, have we not had septic issues for a number of years here going on? I mean, how do we qualify for this so quickly when this is not a topic that came up overnight, is it?
Well, it came up overnight that we have a failed...
But it's been failed. I mean, we've had this, I've seen septic issues for a while here, have we not? How long have we been...
Well, we've been managing the septic system for the last few years. When I first started here, the playground...
It's been having issues for more than a year, dude. I mean, issues. I mean, I'm not saying failed, but it's been showing signs of...
It hasn't failed. We've had different various issues where we believe maybe a pump was going out, or last year we believe the circuit boards were not synchronizing correctly, so we redid the circuit boards on it. So we've been managing different problems that arise with it. But when this year water came to the surface that was not healthy water, that could cause problems for our kids, that's when we broke it off and said, okay, we need to really dig in and investigate what's going on with it.
When did that happen? When did that complaint come through?
I'd have to go back and look at my notes. I don't have that right off the top of my head, but I believe it was somewhere around March time frame, somewhere in there.
I think that's right.
I was going to say, I think we talked about it in a meeting in your report, though I don't remember that.
I would have to go back and check my notes.
Well, see, I mean, so, okay, got all that. So, We're still kind of being forced with doing that project without looking into elsewhere, though. I mean, I feel we got to make that decision today whether we're going to go ahead and do this, whatever you
well,
want
I mean,
this, compared to not looking into moving it to a better place.
I think we can look into moving it to a better place, but you got to keep in mind that if we aren't designing on this Monday, quite frankly, I don't think we can make the dates.
So in essence, it may not be the best choice to make, but we got to do it because we got to open school on the end of the summer.
The other choice is you leave it marked off just like you've got it, and you go up here and you find another area. We have to do some perk tests and some other things like that, which all take time. The 4 weeks will become 2 months, type of thing.
I understand.
And get that in, whether school's running or not. Doesn't have an impact. You're just going to block that off like you have been. Get this in and pump it. Pay more, that's correct.
You're quite a big project, I would think.
Well, my estimation is it would be at least $200,000.
Yeah. It's only $50,000 more. I understand saying that, but what's in our reserve fund?
Well, I'm not proposing we spend $150,000. I don't want to be misled on that.
Well, it's between $100,000 and $150,000.
He's trying to keep from having to take it out of our general fund.
I understand that, but what's in our reserve fund as we speak?
We're sitting at about 9% of the general fund.
So that's got to be close to $500,000.
Close.
So we have $500,000 in our reserve fund.
Correct. But remember, here's the issue, and this is what, you know, I'm big about trying to protect reserves. I'm not overly excited that we're dipping into it. Every year that I've been here, we've tried to take monies and stick it into the reserves for this rainy day. We have a bad case scenario. Now, if we go and we deplete that reserve and then that next drain field that is older decides to go on us.
You're not talking about depleting it, you're only taking 200 of a half a million. That's far from depleting.
And it's possible, it really is possible.
Half a million sounds bigger than just saying 500,000. You're gonna take 200,000 out of it, and maybe another two, and pretty soon you have nothing. Legally, you have to have a certain amount in there. Or you try to build it up.
You try, you can't have.
You can have a max, and you can't have a max, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just speaking up, you know, as I like to do, I'm just.
No, it's.
To me, another $50,000 to get sewage off our playground is not a whole lot. That's, to me, pretty minimal. If we have a half a million in our fund and we're just keeping it for a rainy day, I would say that's a hell of a lot more important to do that than to what we're trying to do, that's my opinion.
Yes, sir.
Do we have to get a permit from the Valley County? Would they have some input on this?
They would, yes. But I don't believe they give the permit, DEQ gives the permit. Valley County isn't a permit issuing county. There's certain things that they deal with, small household type of things. This is a public system, it would go to DEQ. They would look for input from Valley County, but it would be approved by the DEQ.
So they're gonna, because we are a public water source and we're a public sewer source, they're gonna have requirements imposed upon us that are a little more stringent than ordinary household requirements. And that's why all the plans are gonna have to be submitted to DEQ for approval. They're going to rake it over and make sure that the I's are dotted and the T's are crossed.
Have you got any idea of what you might do up there? Or nothing at all at this point?
If we were daydreaming, we'd build a whole new building and, you know, a whole new school. That's the daydream. But the reality is that's $25 or $30 million that we don't have a finger on.
How much, do you have an idea of space? Like how many square feet of footprint do you need?
I wasn't on that committee that had that daydream, and I don't really know.
So I mean, if you take the 10 acres and you take a piece of it, you know, obviously some's gotta be parking lot, and the drain field obviously can't be schoolyard, you don't want it that, and you don't want it to be, you want to fence it off and not use it. Mm-hmm. Why go through this again? So, you know, you just kind of look at that, because you definitely want to be able to take what's there out there, what's here out there, what's over here up there, or if you close everything and do it, you know, whatever you might want to do, you could definitely reuse it mm-hmm. for whatever you need to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it, you know, it really is possible to do that. I mean, you know, I think that he could cordon off an area up there, whether it's around the baseball diamonds up there, that's part of our property or not, and just say, we're going to cordon off this area.
You want to
make
grass on the side of the highway.
And stuff. I mean, the only thing that you're going to run into up here is you got a lot of big trees, and you're going to be up brick trees and stuff to get very good leveled off and ready to run.
Can we get an estimate to do it? I mean, how long did it take you to throw this together for an estimate?
4 or 5 hours. Yeah. I mean, it'd just be a matter of coming back here probably, today's Thursday? Coming back here tomorrow and walking around up there a little bit.
Seems logical to me to at least.
Though I don't know if we're looking at a project that we think is going to come in at $100,000 and we're asking for to do a budget amendment of $150,000 for contingencies, then if we think the project's going to cost $200,000, then we really probably ought to get $225,000 or $250,000. So. You know, in case, you know, because it's going to cost money to take down the trees. It's going to cost money to.
Well, the pipeline going up there, you know, mm-hmm. that you're going to go either on public streets or through an easement of some type. Do you own land right down to the road here?
Yeah, we could get right on our property.
Get on the property, okay.
Basically, the only thing, you know, but you do get into issues. I mean, there is fiber optic and there is piping and there are gas lines and stuff that run through this area. So, however, you know, I don't know if they're going to bring in a directional bore or what to get under the road, how they're going to get the piping in.
Well, could you give us that complete estimate?
Typically, if you're looking for cheapest, a contractor will just excavate and go under or over or whatever he has to do to get around things and go slower. We're talking of 40, 50, 40 bucks a foot to put in a line that's a force main. And we're talking $200, $250 a foot to jack something, or not through a casing, but to bore something under the road. I mean, it's huge. If you bore it for 200 feet times 200, and there's $40,000. Whereas if you just cut it and had to repair the road and do all that stuff, maybe you're as much as $50 or $60 a foot. So that would be 180.
Well, I know before when we were putting cabling in, because we were trying to put fiber optic cable from that building to here, the state would not allow us to cut that road.
Okay, then you'd have
we had to bore.
That is a state, that's the state road?
That's the old state highway there, so.
And they still control it?
I'm not sure if they do or the county, but we could not
then
cut that road. They required.
Then usually, I mean, I've had that situation before, especially when it's a state highway. They won't let you cut. They won't let you cut it, so you bore under it.
But that, you know, we excavated from here down next
yep.
to the road.
Yep.
We bored under the road, then we came back up and excavated to the remainder part of the building
yep.
that we needed to get our cable into.
Understand.
I have a question. If we take the time to check out the big project, and we finally decide that we don't want to do that, we want to go back for the smaller, are we going to take the chance that we're going to still be messing around when school starts in the fall?
Well, that was a question I had for you, Terry, because you said something that worries me a little bit, and that is the DEQ is experiencing a high volume of septic drains that are used. And if that's the case, and they would work hard to try to get it to us in 2 weeks, but if some unforeseen thing happened that it took them 4 weeks or 5 weeks, would we still have enough time to get that initial phase of the drain filled in that would be operational, or could we be running into a delay of school start?
I think we would be able to get in one of the three drain fields.
Because that's my biggest fear is we don't start on time.
Yeah,
and then you throw all the parents in the community, their schedules and everything up in the air, because they've planned their lives around their kids mm-hmm. going to school at this time. And because we have a project that had delays for whatever reason, that it now has prevented us from being able to get our target date.
I understand. But the type of situation we'd have there is we'd have some chain link fence put up, and it would probably go all the way over to the sidewalk and cut down to the other chain link fence, and we'd block the whole area off, and that would be the construction until we were done.
And as long as we were able to get the sewage taken care of
yep.
and not have to be pulling in trucks to pump it
correct.
Out.
Correct. And that's one of the reasons that you really don't necessarily want the little bitty guy who has him and his son, because we also got to dig a big hole and put another septic tank out there next to that modular building. And that's got to go on the same time somebody's doing the work on the drain fields. So it's more than just a couple of people. And there's going to have to be a lot of material hauled in and a lot of material hauled off. But it is good to know that we could haul that material up here on your property.
We've got other spots we could put it to.
I mean, that's close. I mean, that would work. So, and because I've already figured that we could still get it done if everything just really clicked nicely, but it never happens. So if we even went 3 weeks over, I've already got 1 week of cushion in here. So that's, you know, that's one that we just have. But if it went 3 weeks over, that means if you use my cushion one, that'd be 2 weeks. And we just would have something completed. So we have a drain field to use, possibly two, and then finish up.
Well, Colby's right. This has been an ongoing problem for several years. There's always been some issue with it. And I think what this fellow's saying is we can overhaul what we've got for $150,000, and it'll work for 40 years. That sounds pretty good to me.
Council saying we can do that and prefer we don't walk on it, but we have.
Well, it'll get walked on, but you know how every spring it freezes, thaws out, it gets loose again. There is nothing absolutely perfect. But we can do it for, and if we can get 30 or 40 years, then it might even go longer than that. As porous as this ground is around here. And filters, now they've got filters coming out of septic tanks. If you're diligent about pumping your tank, cleaning that filter.
And you do have a filter out there, but it's a relatively large filter. I mean, quite a bit bigger stuff can go through it.
Yeah, I'm sure they make smaller mesh and stuff.
And if you change it more often?
Mm-hmm. Do maybe a budget.
Well, we do have a schedule on cleaning that filter, too. I mean, Dennis is out there pulling that. And, you know, we ended up getting a secondary filter so that he can pull one, put the other one in, take the one and clean it. And then he puts it in storage until he goes and swaps them out again. So he does have a schedule for trying to clean those filters.
And weren't you saying that if we did the smaller thing that we were talking about, that would be good for 30 or 40 years, the part that we fixed, but didn't you say there's another part that could go any time and we'd be in the same position? Yes. My other question is, I'm just throwing this out so everybody can process it all, is if we fix the smaller thing and put off the big project, and then say next year we decided to do the big project, would we be duplicating some of the stuff, or would some of the stuff on the small project would have been unnecessary if we'd went ahead and did the big thing?
When you say the big thing, you mean up there?
The one that goes across the road.
Yeah,
that one.
It would be duplicating it.
So some of the stuff we'd be doing on the littler project wouldn't be necessary if we did the big project coming across the road.
I guess if the idea of doing the big project up there, if the idea is to get it out of the of the school ground, which I can't argue, I mean, I can't even argue against it. I mean, it's absolutely the best thing you could do. You could dig those trenches back up, take out the domes and reuse them again. And that would be all you'd save. You'd have to strip back all the sod and everything, dig those out, fill it, probably from some soil up there, put the sod back on it, and now you have a play yard, at least on the north end, with no grain field under it.
Ideally, we would fence this third of an acre off, let nobody on it. But we could also use it.
For what?
Playground.
Up there? Or down
here?
Yes. That's why I'm going a little deeper. You could use it.
That's what I'm saying, because all that's down there, if you got a filter and everything and you keep your septic tanks in shape, all you got is a little gray water.
Well, I was going to say, we're going to, of course, be changing our practice of what we dump down the drain a little bit here, I think.
Well, yeah, there's going to have to be a management plan sort of place that everybody is trained on and understands so that we don't end up...
What did you ever do with the art department about dumping their paint down the drains? Because I know years ago that all got lumped up down there because they were...
Well, what they did is they put a...
different drain,
what do you call those?
Grease trap.
Oh, okay.
And so that gets regularly cleaned out also.
Okay, well, I'm just going to say this about the gray water. I'm in the, you know, I work in a business where microbial activity in the soil is everything, and that's what makes the whole world go. And I can't explain the science really, but it's fairly miraculous if you can take City of Kalispell or City of Missoula sewage sludge or City of Milwaukee or any place and make it into usable soil and fertilizer. The microbial activity that's in the soil, the planet would have imploded by now if we didn't have microbial activity that keeps the planet alive. And so if we're changing out the soil and we've got it fixed so the water is going to go down and it's not coming up, we've got some clean stuff on top, I think that's, I mean, I like the idea of
planning for the future, but we don't have unlimited money to it. I mean, I think that's the ultimate way to go, because like Mal goes, I'd rather build a whole new building than try to open this one up and, you know what I mean?
But you don't know the cost, we're calling this a big project.
Yeah.
When you're giving me a number, maybe, we don't know it. I have no clue what it's gonna say, other than you can tell me you can do it in a few hours, but we're bypassing, I see that as the only logical next step to make. Look at that, and then decide. I mean, I'm reading through you, it's bad to have that where it's at, and I totally agree with that. I know that. I mean, that makes common sense, but to not know this cost up here and then start calling it a big project is, I don't see it that way. It's an unknown project at this point. We don't know, but I sure as heck like the feeling of moving sewage away from our kids. And that's, I like that.
The one thing that could get you into trouble, for the next one that happens down there, the south one, is if you built another one right there in that grass, you have no replacement area unless we start designating it up there. I mean, DEQ is going to require me to have a replacement area, the same, actually bigger, because this is a bed. I have to have a replacement area as if they were trenches, so it gets another third bigger at least. So I'd have to designate that somewhere, up there, over here, but I don't want to do it here. I didn't realize you had it there. But if you got that whole thing there, you'd have to go up there with the replacement. I mean, that's what DEQ would require. Which I don't see that would be difficult to say, because we're going to put it up there.
You're basically just saying that's where we would have to pump it if in fact that one went down.
Yeah.
And we're still only fixing half of our drain field for this project.
But the other half isn't broke.
I put it in 91. I know that's a
kind of older than 91.
Yeah, it's old, way older.
Even older. I mean, my research on septics is I think you get 10. Some of them give you 10, max 10 years. Boy, I'm pushing.
Depending on the soil type. Usually gravels, you can get a little more than that. But yeah, it's wearing out. There's no question in my mind.
Well, I think if you're diligent about taking care of your septic tank, pumping it, not just letting it go.
I think what it is, though, it's undersized. That's really the problem. I mean, you could clean the tank all the time. The tank that I saw, and I know there's one more tank that's out underneath a building. I mean, that's how you look at it over here.
Yeah, it's under the trailer.
Under that monster, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. It just seems like you don't have enough. Like, I doubt very much that you have more than 10,000 gallons there at the very most. And if it's half the kids, you should be up somewhere around 15. And the drain field lengths are very small, just like the ones over there are. We have 1,700 feet of drain field over there right now, today. And what I'm putting in is 3,600. That's the difference. So
well,
I
would say this, I'll be honest with you. Before I came here, the septic drain field was a huge issue. When they had septic flowing down Long Avenue, You know how the community was stirred up over it. Mm-hmm. We've been extremely fortunate in the past 8 years that I've been here not to have septic issues. And when a student said that they had smelly clothes because they stepped in water that stunk, I think we were very fortunate it didn't blow up into a huge issue again. And what Colby says is a point that needs to be given serious thought, because if we can move it up here, get it completely away, and have all the dosing chambers and everything sized for the event of the other drain field going bad, and we can move it all up here, you're taking care of the issue
once and for all.
Once and for all, permanently. And the thing is, you're not going to have the kids being impacted by it at all.
So is that going to, if we did it, I mean, okay, this is what we need to do. You need to come back out, and you need to give us a bid on what that project would be, so that we have a comparison, and then we need to go from
there.
That'd
make it easier before we have that.
But tonight, you know, tonight isn't about approving a project.
It's about
setting them out. But then again, you know, you could set the budget proclamation for $250 tonight.
we're not going to spend.
Don't have to use it.
So you can get the whole process going. We can get numbers back from Terry, and we could take a look, and the board can give him direction as to which way do you want to go.
So why do we need to? Why are you saying we need to set that? What's the purpose of doing that tonight?
The proclamation to get the budgeting process rolling so that.
If we can turn it into OPI before Friday, which is tomorrow, right? Isn't that what we want to do? Get it turned in.
We're going to announce the proclamation so that by June 11th we can set the budget amendment amount.
Okay.
And then Terry needs to get work, and he has to start work designing. You said by tomorrow.
Well, I was having a survey crew come up and do the surveying tomorrow, and that's how tight my time is. If we're really seriously thinking of moving up there, I wouldn't even waste the money on doing a survey here, quite frankly.
I just don't know how we can make a decision without looking, without one.
How about this? We fix that down there. Next summer, through the year, we'd look, see how much money it's going to cost. Just bring it, not put the field in up here, but maybe put a pipe up here. Sooner or later.
You said that that's probably kind of wasting your nothing's reusable, so it's...
You mean what's there now?
I mean, if say we fix that there now, throw $150,000 on it, then we decide next year to go up there, I mean, does that make sense to you?
We wouldn't go up there unless we had to.
Unless the other one fails?
Yeah. And I don't think you would see any problem for several years. I mean, this thing should go 30 or 40 years on the new one.
But you'd have no clue on the...
At all.
If that hits us, then we're...
If we do the proclamation for the $250,000, we're not necessarily going to use it.
And then we have time to get a bid from in and take a look at it.
We can go on either plan that way because we've got the groundwork done. Okay. But it doesn't mean we're going to spend that. But we'll
spend some time of yours to investigate up here and get some numbers to us.
I could probably do that by end of day Monday. Okay. I could get you some numbers.
And so, essentially...
So by our board meeting, that would be...
Well, we're going to want to go in this direction before then.
We'll have to have another meeting.
So we could have another meeting, say, Tuesday night, if that's all right with everybody.
And the regular meetings will be good.
Well, then we need a motion for the budget amendment proclamation, is that correct?
June 4th, you want to read this?
Okay, I'll make a motion that, let me just read the whereas.
Budget proclamation is presented.
The budget amendment proclamation for the Florence Carlton School of Ravalli County. Whereas the trustees of School District Number 15-6, Ravalli County, Montana, have made a determination that there is an unforeseen need of the district of a failed septic drain field that cannot be postponed without affecting the safety of students and employees or the educational functions of the district. The district's budget for the general fund does not provide sufficient financing to properly maintain and support the district for the entire current school year. And whereas the trustees have determined that an amendment to the elementary high school general fund budget in the amount of $250,000 necessary under the provision of section 20-9-16-6 MCA, and whereas the anticipated source of financing the budget amendment expenditures shall be general fund reserves. Therefore be it resolved that the Board of Trustees of School District Number 15-6, Ravalli County, Montana, proclaims the need for an amendment to the elementary high school general fund budget for the fiscal year 2012-2013 in the amount of $250,000 under the section 20-9-16-6 MCA for the purpose identified above, and be it further resolved that the Board of Trustees of School District Number 15-6, Ravalli County, Montana, will meet at 7 p.m. at the Florence Carlton School District Conference Room on June 11, 2013, for the purpose of considering and adopting the budget amendment.
Second.
That be June 4th then now, or just...
No, 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 because remember the timeframe from the proclamation to the budget.
In the week, yeah.
We need that week, so...
I'm gonna go up and do this really quick.
Yeah.
And then after the fiscal year...
You can do it after the meeting.
Fiscal year 2012-13.
Correct.
It's not 13-14.
It's the current general fund, right?
Yeah, it's a current general.
Okay, so I have a motion and a second, do we need to have any more discussion? So basically, we've come to, we're gonna meet again on Tuesday the 4th at, can we be 6:30? Can we go 6:30? All right, so this is June 4th, 6:30. And we are gonna get some more numbers and info from you, right?
Get a vote on this.
And so I'm finishing the discussion on this motion.
Who seconded it in here?
Dorothy, I'm sorry, yeah.
Can I say one more thing?
We're in discussion, you can keep talking.
Well, all I wanna do is question this fellow. What's your name, Terry?
Terry, yes.
Terry, the way I understand this, you would never see water on top of the ground anyway. Again, if we fix it right.
That's correct.
The grass might be a little greener, but you keep mowing it and the sun takes care of it.
You can guarantee that?
But I don't think the question is not about the one that we're gonna fix.
Right.
The question is about the old one underneath the elementary school that is older than this one that possibly could go bad, and if it does, then we don't know where to go with it. I think that's what the issue is, because I agree with you. I think he can fix the new one, and I think we can use it. If we could promise that the old one would behave itself and keep working.
Which we can, so maybe next summer we'd have to pipe up here at least.
And that's true, that would be an option.
Well, we're not gonna do anything until we see another number.
That's right. So, call for question. All those in favor of the budget amendment proclamation?
Aye.
Opposed? We're all good. All right.